over the mountains and the seas. Your river runs with love for me, and I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm so happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down.
Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me, and I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down, yeah. I could sing of your love forever. 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 Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me, and I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down, yeah. I could sing of your love forever. 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 Ooh, I feel like dancing. It's foolishness, I know. But when the world has seen the light, they will dance with joy like we're dancing now. I could sing of your love forever. 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 I could sing of your love. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love
What a wonderful call to worship led by Reverend Tim. I will sing of your love forever. Welcome to our service for the 28th of February, our second service this year in Lent. I hope you will enjoy the service and our Lord and Father God will speak to you through our worship. So let us pray. Father God, we want to sing of your love forever. We want the healer to truly set us free. Set us free to serve you in newness of life. Set us free to serve and love one another. So may this time of Lent be a time of discovery, a time of growth, a time of reimagining for ourselves and our churches. And may we find Jesus at the centre of our lives, at the very centre of our being. We come to you humbly, on our knees if need be, to see you face to face, to come under your shade, to feel you both day and night, to feel your arm stretched out to us and your strength being administered to us when we need it most. Heal us, lift us, carry us, but most of all, open our eyes that we may look to the hills and declare our help comes from the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. And so, journey with us, we pray. We ask it in the name of Jesus, our Lord and our Redeemer. Amen. Two readings of scripture now. First from Anne Murray from Scotscap Chapel, who will be reading Psalm 121. And then from Johnny from Hedden, who will be reading Luke and chapter 7, the story of the centurion from Capernaum. Enjoy the service.
I am reading Psalm 121 from my favourite version of the Bible. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. He that keepeth Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even for evermore. Amen.
Standing on the promises of God, my Saviour, standing. verses 1 to 10. When Jesus had finished saying all these things to the people, he went to Capernaum. A Roman officer there had a servant who was very dear to him. The man was sick and about to die. When the officer heard about Jesus, he sent some Jewish elders to ask him to come and heal his servant. They came to Jesus and begged him earnestly, "This man really deserves your help. He loves our people and he himself built a synagogue for us." So Jesus went with them. He was not far from the house when the officer sent friends to tell him, "Sir, don't trouble yourself. I do not deserve to have you come into my house. Neither do I consider myself worthy to come to you in person. Just give the order and my servant will get well. I too am a man placed under the authority of superior officers, and I have soldiers under me. I order this one, go, and he goes. I order that one, come, and he comes. And I order my slave, do this, and he does it." Jesus was surprised when he heard this. He turned round and said to the crowd following him, "I tell you, I have never found faith like this, not even in Israel." The messengers went back to the officer's house and found his servant well.
My text today is taken from Psalm 121 and the opening two verses. "I will lift my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth." So let us pray. Lord, open your words to our hearts. Open our minds as we journey with Jesus through this time of Lent. May it be a time of pruning unto righteousness and grace, a time of equipping and fruitfulness. We ask these things in the name of Jesus, our Lord and our Redeemer. Amen. Have you ever found yourself stuck between a rock and a hard place? Maybe like the England cricket team last week, you found yourself on a sticky wicket. Or maybe you found yourself up the stream without a paddle, frantic, trying to find a safe bank to feel ground again. Or you might be one of those people who never feels pressure in any situation and just go with the flow, so to speak. In general though, life will from time to time bring us to that point where it would seem we have nowhere to turn, nowhere to get that much needed help, whichever way we seem to look. It would seem to me that it was like that often for the writer of Psalm 121. In order to write this song, he had, I believe, experienced the opposite, maybe even utter dereliction, as he journeyed to this moment of revelation and assurance. Psalm 121, or a song of accents as it's sometimes called, comes from a heart that understands brokenness. That this life that we all have can and does sometimes break us. This truth is not lost on the writer. Because of this, the writer can give us this moment of great writing. encouraging the reader to look expectantly to the hills. In doing so, he gives us one of the greatest pictures of faith that we can find in the Bible. I look to the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. When life is a storm, when our eyes are red with sorrow and despair, when we can barely lift up our heads, never mind look to the hills, the advice the writer gives is, lift up your head. Look expectantly to the hills, with eyes and heart, and then journey on, however long it takes, because our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I don't know about you, but I've always enjoyed going to the cinema. I can remember meeting the character Lieutenant Dan for the first time. His expectancy when you first meet him in the film was to lay down his life for his country, just like many of his ancestors had done before him. The only problem is, Forrest Gump saves his life, and Lieutenant Dan is carried off the battlefield. And for him, life became a storm. And we get to the point of him asking his friend, where is your God?
No, shrimp.
Where the hell's this God of yours?
It's funny Lieutenant Dan said that, because right then, God showed up. Now me, I was scared, but Lieutenant Dan, he was mad.
You call this a storm? Oh, you son of a bitch! Oh! It's time for a showdown! You and me! I'm right here! Come and get me! You'll never sink this boat!
I've been there, and I know many of you have been there. Where is God? And in the film, it's the most unlikely place where God turns up. The cry that Lieutenant Dan makes in the storm is, you will not sink this boat. And he's talking about himself there, not the craft he sails on. You will not sink this boat. Very much a cry of defiance and hope from a life of utter despair. In our gospel story from Luke, the centurion from Capernaum was also going through his own storm. The person he held most dear was dying. He too, in his darkest moment, his time of crisis understands where his help comes from. His help comes from the Lord, maker of heaven and earth. And in verse 3, we read this. So when he heard about Jesus, he sent elders of the Jews to him, pleading with him to come and heal his servant. In his darkest need, he pleads for help. He pleads for hope. Not for himself, but for another. Someone whose life he admires, his servant. And we see the faith of the psalmist here too. Despite the circumstances the centurion finds himself in, he turns to the God who he knows. The God he knows who will not let your feet slip, who will not slumber when you need him most. A keeper who keeps, a shade when it's needed, and a strong hand to save. Someone whom you can turn to day or night. The sun shall not strike you by day, or the moon by night, the psalmist says. The sun and the moon, symbols for the 24-hour protection that we get from God. And further to this, it's worth remembering the Hebrew word for keep that the psalmist uses here is actually used 6 times throughout the song. 6 times. He used it, it seems to me, in a dramatic way to further emphasize the care we receive from God. In a similar way, the poet Joseph Scriven wrote a poem to comfort his mother. Tragically, Joseph's fiancée had drowned in a tragic accident the day before he was due to be married. He wrote the poem that we know as the hymn, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus," to comfort his mother in a time of great loss. Joseph uses the name of Jesus as our help, and in one of the verses says this: "Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? You should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer." Likewise, our centurion turns to the Lord, humbled that the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, our healer and friend, will come to his aid and the aid of his servant. And he turns expectantly, although in his own words, he has no right to ask and is unworthy. His ensuing conversation with Jesus leaves Jesus saying that he has never come across such faith anywhere in Israel. I return briefly to Lieutenant Dan, who, because of his friend Forrest, finds that peace with God. and discovers not only a purpose for life, but also becomes grateful for life itself.
Forrest. I never thanked you for saving my life.
He never actually said so, but I think he made his peace with God.
So, what can we learn today? We can learn that there is no shame in a cry for help. And although we can often think otherwise, it's never too late to start that journey of seeking and looking to the hills. I know that it might seem easy for me to say this. I know that getting through the day is sometimes a serious business, and at times we need legitimate help just to put one foot in front of the other. I remind you again that hundreds of years before Jesus was even born, the psalmist wrote to remind us that the help is there. The title of the 121st psalm in the NIV is God, the Help of Those Who Seek. There is a but though. There is a but. We, the saints alive today, are preserved. I repeat that, we are preserved. But not in the sense we will never suffer adversity, but that we will go through adversity and come out winners. We will go through adversity and will come out winners. So the last verse of this writer's song says, "The Lord shall preserve you from evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time and forevermore." So, dear friends, as we journey through Lent, I remind you of the words of another poet whose song we will sing later, that of Don Moen. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide, hold me closely to his side. With love and strength for each new day, he will make a way. He will make a way. God bless you all. Amen. A short prayer. Heavenly Father, journey with us through this time of Lent. Draw close to us. Help us to lift our head and gently hold us wherever we find ourselves in this journey. May we look expectantly to the hills. Find you by our side, our healer and our friend. Amen. We come now to our prayers of intercession for our second Sunday in Lent. Let us pray. Followers of the way of Christ, let us bring to our Heavenly Father the needs of our times. Father, we pray for your blessing on all who confess belief in you, that they may witness powerfully to your unselfish love and humility by the way they act and the lives they lead. Father, lead us and free us from all that is evil. Father, we pray for your blessing on all who administer justice, those working in the law courts and serving on juries, and those who make our laws, that they may be given insight and integrity. Father, lead us, free us from all that is evil. Father, we pray for your blessing on us during this Lent, as we examine our lives and draw closer to you, that through our self-discipline and prayer, we may enter your stillness and know your will for us. Father, lead us, free us from all that is evil. Father, we pray for your blessing on all in prison or on probation, on those living in acute poverty or in refugee camps, on all who work among them to heal, redirect, support and encourage. Father, lead us, free us from all that is evil. Father, we pray for your blessing on all those who have passed through death, especially those who have died without family around them, without friends to take them by the hand, without their loved ones around them. We pray for those too suffering such loss, not being able to support their loved ones in their time of need. Father, lead us and free us from all that is evil. May we one day share with them eternal life in your presence. In silence, Father, we bring to you our individual concerns and joys, and we look to these moments to look to the hills from whence our help comes. These and all our prayers we offer in the name of Christ, our Lord and our Redeemer. Amen. Kathy Anderson will now lead us in singing the Lord's Prayer, which will be followed by our final hymn, God Will Make a Way Where There Seems No Other Way.
Our Father in heaven, Into temptation.
I just want to say a big thank you to everybody who took part in our service today. To Tim and Kathy for leading our worship. To Anne and Johnny for reading our lessons. For Matt for helping with the filming. Grateful thanks. Our final blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with us all this day and forevermore. Amen.